Hey guys, welcome back to my channel MI Tutorials. In this particular tutorial, I'm going to teach you how to create a custom KPI card. Now, what I mean by custom KPI card is basically the card that you see over here. Right now, it is comparing the sales value of this year versus the last year, and it is telling us that we've made a good progress on our sales, which is up by 32%, right? Now, this is a measure-driven number that we see here. For example, now this is actually comparing the sales from 2020 with 2019. So let us change this quickly to show you how this exactly works. So if I change this from 2020 to 2021, and let's compare this with 2020 sales, right? And let us see what happens. So the moment I click enter over here, the values here change to negative, and there's an icon placed over here which is saying that the sales have gone down. And then we've got this little percentage icon as well. All right, so I'm going to teach you how to do this. So let's get started. First of all, I'm not going to teach in this how to create a measure. The calculation over here, it is right here. I'm just basically doing subtraction and then division to calculate the percentage value. Now, how do we give the or how do we create this particular icon over here? So all you need to do is create a new measure, and let's call this measure as icon 2, because I already have one icon which I've created earlier. So I'm going to start typing in a variable over here. Variable, I need one variable for positive icon, and then I'm going to say is equals to, I'm going to use the function called unicare over here. Unicare value for the positive icon is 9650. I'm going to use that, and then let's create another one over here and call this as negative icon. Okay, is equals to unicard, and then this is 9660. Okay, let's type in the another variable for the result. Okay, and then is equals to, if my sales versus last year, the measure which was already there, is greater than zero, then I need the positive icon. Then let's bring in then positive icon. Okay, else negative icon. Okay, I'm going to close the if bracket over here, and then I'm going to say return result. Okay, and then press enter. So you have your icon 2 which is created. Let's bring this into a new KPI into a new card over here. So okay, we now have the icon created. So let us go here and turn on the category labels and also the background. Okay, now let us also bring in the sales versus last year percentage value, okay, into another card. Let us click a card, change this to a card. Okay, now we will bring this also into a card. Okay, now let us change the color of these icons so that whenever the value changes, it has to dynamically change, right? So let us create another measure over here. Okay, call this as icon color 2. Okay, and then I'm going to say if my sales versus last year is greater than zero, then return green, else return red. Okay, this is the DAX I'm going to use here to identify whether it's a positive or a negative. Okay, once this is created, let's go to the formatting tab. Click on this icon over here and go to the formatting tab, and under the data label over here, click on this conditional formatting, and then go to field value and then select icon color 2. Okay, and then click on okay. The moment you click that, you will see that the color has now changed. Okay, let us do the same thing for the value here as well. Let's go to the conditional formatting and the field value. Let us type in icon color 2. Okay, and then click on OK. So this will also change, right? So to know that this is working fine, so we will change these value here to compare data with the previous year. So for example, we're now comparing with 2021. Let's compare this with 2020 and 2019 to see if it is working or not. Let's do this and see what happens. So let's press enter now, and then you will see that the values have changed and the measure has also changed the color automatically, including the icon. So you can place the icon over here and then create various things with this, and you can create multiple KPI cards like this to identify whether it is green or red, right? Yeah, I hope this video has helped you and you've learned something new. Please consider subscribing to my channel for more such tutorials.